Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we're going to be taking a look at how to use the accessibility checker within Microsoft Word. It is not perfect and it does not replace the need for you to manually check your documents for accessibility. I like to use the accessibility checker at the very end of my document remediation process to ensure that all of the things that I've done were implemented correctly. So let's begin using the accessibility checker within Microsoft Word. In a perfect world, you've already applied all of your basic accessibility features to your Microsoft Word document. So some of the things that you might look for before running the accessibility checker are things like headings. Did you apply a heading structure throughout your document? Do your images have alternate text applied? Are your list elements properly formatted using the list feature from the paragraph tab? Have you validated your alternate text in the other images in your document? Do your tables have headings? Does all of the font pass color contrast requirements? Let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker. We will just kind of jump in from there. So to run the accessibility checker, you have two different methods. And the first one I'm going to do is select review, and then I'm going to choose check accessibility. This brings up a window on the right hand side that displays our errors, warnings, and additional things. So the errors are things that are found to be barriers to accessibility, and you should definitely fix those. Microsoft Word has made this easy by adding a drop down menu on all of the errors and warnings of places that you can actually fix right here within the accessibility checker. So if I wanted to, I could add a description to this pie chart, or I could simply mark as decorative. And because I have a fantastic description underneath the image, I'm going to actually mark this one as decorative. And then if we select back our accessibility checker button, we can go on to the next issue. And the next issue is that this table does not have a header row applied. Now, if I want, I could go into the home tab, select table design, and select header row, or I could simply select use first row as a header for this table. Next, we have images or objects are not in line. Whenever you are working with images of any kind, they need to be set in line or marked as decorative for accessibility purposes. Now, in this particular example, because I have two separately inserted shape elements, I want to have them as a singular object. This makes it easier for me to move them around or to change the settings on the back end so that they pass our accessibility requirements. All right, so to make both of these objects a group, I'm gonna select both of them, and under Shape Format, I'm gonna go to the Group tab and select Group. This then allows me to deal with these objects as one unit instead of two units. So next, I can apply alternate text to this group. In this example, I'm just gonna mark as decorative for now. And then that also removes the inline error because we changed it to a single group. If both of these objects were sitting on top of each other, we would want to set them to inline, and that would fix that accessibility error also. And then we have an issue with color contrast. This is actually a warning. And when I select the drop-down menu, it allows me to change the font color to something that is going to pass. And so I can choose a dark red or just black in this example. And then let's take a look at the recommended actions for the alt text on this image. Let's select view alt text, and then I'm just going to simply mark as decorative for this demo. And so now the document does pass our built-in accessibility checker, but we want to validate that we applied all of our accessibility elements. So the next part of this would be to walk through this document and make sure everything is working appropriately. We have headings applied, our images have alt text. Now there's some important limitations of the accessibility checker. And in one example, the color contrast isn't always accurate. So sometimes the accessibility checker does not find issues with color contrast. That is one of the downsides of this checker. It also doesn't find things like when your headings are out of order. For example, I could just mark this heading as normal, and then the first heading would be a heading level 2. The accessibility checker doesn't find any problem with this. Additionally, if you have manually created list items, the accessibility checker does not find any of these as errors. And then finally, are hyperlinks, when we have full URLs, the accessibility checker does not find a problem with these. So it's important that you still have that manual check, and I highly recommend using a checklist, especially the first few times that you're validating the accessibility of your Word documents, just to make sure that you're doing everything right. So thank you for joining me today as we walked through some of the benefits and issues of using the accessibility checker within Microsoft Word. Thank you for watching.